Hello everyone, once again welcome to my channel. We are heading towards the end of the chapter 5 now. The last two topics I am going to discuss in this video now. Number 1 is attribute list declaration and number 2 entity. Attribute list declaration. Suppose you need to use an attribute in the XML document, then in the DTD part, you need to declare it by using attList keyword. Its general syntax is, at first you need to specify the keyword attList, then you need to specify element name, then attribute name. Afterwards, you need to specify the type of the default value. For example, suppose you want to create this element. Here, name is the attribute, so in the DTD code, we need to specify like this for the above example. The attribute list declaration contains the following information. Number 1, the element to which an attribute is associated. Number 2, the name of the attribute. Number 3, the type of the attribute. And number 4, the default value of the attribute. Now the next topic is entity. These are some sequence of characters that represents another sequence of characters. Types of entity. Number 1, predefined entity, and number 2, user-defined entity. Here is a table that shows the characters and their corresponding predefined references. Number 1, in order to display less than sign, you need to specify ampersand LT, then at last semicolon. Number 2, in order to display greater than sign, you need to specify ampersand ZT, semicolon. Accordingly, in order to display ampersand sign, you need to specify ampersand AMP, then semicolon. In order to display apostrophe, you need to specify ampersand APOS, then semicolon. Then, in order to display quotation mark, you need to specify ampersand QUOT, then semicolon. For example, suppose you have created this following XML document. Between the contents, you can able to use the entity reference. Then, in the web browser, the output will be shown like this. Clear? Number 2, user defined entity. User defined entity need to specify in the DTD part of the XML document. In order to use the user defined entity, you need to specify a keyword named entity in the DTD code. Its general syntax is entity, then entity name, then within quotation mark, you need to specify the string to be assigned. For example, suppose you have created this following user defined entity in the DTD part. Then, in the web browser, the output will be shown like this. Clear? So, thank you everyone.